Last episode, we discussed the helm enclosure, the aft cockpit enclosure, as well as the shade curtaining and the barbecue and the underfloor storage.
This week we're going to handle the security. We're going to handle the rescue thingy, the
life raft
thing, and some issues, general issues around the security on the high seas.
Yeah.
The naming of the dinghy. Actually, not. It's just the name of the dinghy because we haven't yet named the dinghy.
But let's leave that for last.
I think we had some comments about the sound. And first of all,
update.
Update. So you can maybe see. Look here and look here. So it looks like I dropped my parcel of platters, but this one is completely skewed. You can see that. Tomorrow they're going to break it again and start over. Then also in the comments from last week, the sound that we used is this thing for the GoPro. So it's a 100% GoPro. It has all these little nice things. And then this is a USB-C. So this is now a new thing for the GoPro 5s. And you need to plug it into the side of the GoPro. And then here's the fluffy mic. So we do have the fluffy mic thingy. And then we put it inside here like this. And there's also, we will do this much more better. It's still painful to use this one. So this is the one that goes inside there, or it goes inside there. And we tried both, and it seems like it didn't work.
Doesn't work.
Yeah, so doesn't maybe, work. How do you guys do this? Because this is USB-C.
And it's a GoPro product. So
yeah,
it is actually for it, yeah.
Super, super expensive. So we need to put this one inside the GoPro, and we don't know how to do that. So we tried.
Okay, the first thing on today's item, on the list of items, is the life raft. Where are we going to put this life raft? I believe you're not going to put it in the dedicated space.
Okay, yeah, the life raft has, I'm sure you got, yeah, please. this arm just doesn't want to work at all.
Men can't multitask, but see.
This is this thing. Doesn't want to bend the way it's supposed to bend. It's like very painful. Yeah, so the life raft, one of the first problems that I think many of you guys that is living on a boat have experienced is an 8-man life raft weighs around 48 kilograms. That's according to the specifications. So for the Leopard, they put the life raft in the aft storage locker, the most aft one, the back one. And you have to open it and you have to take it out. And maybe I can take it out. Not with this arm, but maybe with the healthy arm I can take it out. But it weighs 48 kilograms. So if I am unconscious or something happened to me, because it's normally in a very stormy sea situation, so the sea will be quite wild, the boat will be going up and down. So, and you need to take out this 48 kgs. Maybe I can do it. I honestly don't think I will be able to do it in a rough sea. But Pietro, definitely not. It's like a bag of cement, a big bag of cement. That is how heavy the thing
weight,
is.
Yeah.
It's very, very big. So that position for me is, first of all, it's a little bit uncomfortable. I'm not comfy with that. Then the second one is that if we do take it out and we put it somewhere else, then we have additional storage for scuba gear or life jackets and stuff like that, which is easier to take out. So there's two options, alternative options. The other option is to put it on the hardtop, on the bimini. So if you put
right
it
at the top.
So just behind the helm, there's a position where it's strengthened and so on, so you can put it there. Then the other option, which we will take, is the option that we put it on the railing. So Leopard catamaran, they will strengthen that stanchion. So they will put an additional stanchion there where the life raft will be on.
To secure it.
Yeah, and it will be secured there. Now, it brings us to a second point of this thing, and that's the hydrostatic release. So you can actually, we will have a link I think somewhere up here, but also we will have the playlist down there where we actually made a playlist of all the videos that I went through on life rafts. And one of these things is the hydrostatic release. So the hydrostatic release, the way it works, is this thing goes, if it goes into the water, and most of them at this moment I read it's like 3 to 4 meters going down below the surface of the water. Then the pressure will release a sharp knife that actually then hit the rope, and the rope will be split, will be cut, and the life raft will be released. So then it will drift off, and it will start opening up and all of those things. It has also a cord that you have to pull. So if the boat sinks, then the hydrostatic release will release the life raft. And if it goes to a certain depth, the boat goes to a certain depth, it will actually pull the cord, and the cord will then deploy the life raft. And then there's a weak link, and a weak link will then break, and then your life raft is on top. Now, obviously, is there a very big problem? Like as usual, catamarans don't sink. So, what? I'm not sure what we're going to do in this case.
Yeah, well, hopefully it's not going to go to 4 meters before it decides not to sink anymore, because that's not going to happen.
It is a problem, because I don't know what people... I think they need to start changing this thing, because if the cat doesn't go lower than 3 meters, the hydrostatic will not release, first of all. The second thing is the ripcord will not be ripped, so we need to rip it ourselves. And if you look at the videos in the video playlist, the raft playlist, life raft playlist, you will actually see that the Coast Guard actually pushed this thing off, and I tried to pull it, and I have to push it like a couple of times off before it actually deployed.
Doesn't sound like an option.
I'm not sure. So it is made for monohulls, which is sinking in bad conditions, but a cat doesn't sink. So I'm not sure how we could. So I would like to see comments from our viewers to actually tell us, what do you do in that situation? I don't want to be in that situation to start off. That I think is pretty much clear. But yeah, what other solution is there?
Tie it to the dinghy's anchor and throw the anchor down.
Oh. Oh, we can drop the anchor, yeah.
If there's going to be time for that one, though.
Yeah, we will have a spare anchor as well. So maybe we can assemble the mantis and like and throw it overboard.
4 meters, yeah. There's 4 meters.
But the thing is, we have to keep the life raft close to the boat. Mm. So the life raft needs to be attached to the boat because the cat doesn't sink, and it's just bigger, right? Mm. So if someone flies with an airplane or something, then they can see you better. So the first rule is stay with the boat as long as possible. Only if the boat sinks, you cannot stay with the boat. You can try, but I don't think you will survive. It's not also visible at the bottom of the sea. So the cat doesn't sink, so it will stay up. It will flip upside down, maybe, and it will be upside down. And then the life raft will come in. Because I think on the rough seas, if you try to stay on the hulls, there's propellers, there's rudders, there's all sorts of things that can actually cut and eat you and bruise you. So you would like to be on a life raft, but still attached
to the cat.
To the catamaran. So we need to tie it up so it doesn't break off at least. So,
okay. So you mentioned life jackets. What's the thing with the life jackets?
Okay, so life jackets. You get the normal orange ones that you go up, and it actually, and the reason why it's so funny, yucky life jackets, is that the life jacket actually supports your head. So if you're unconscious, it turns your head upside down and you float like this. But in a rough seas, it's still rough. But that is the general idea, is that the life raft actually supports your neck. So you, and this one floats to the top.
This one
floats to the top. So your position will be like this, and your nose and mouth will be on top. So that's the main idea of a life raft. And that is what the Coast Guards, or even the South African Coast Guard, also want to know, is that it must conform to that the head is up. So we will have those ones as well. I think if we have many other guests, we will have that because we need them. But the more expensive option is the one that's also a harness. So the harness, and I'll show you the photos. So the harness is a thing that is like a harness, and the winds, life jackets, this one is a harness. And for me, I'm not going to promote any brands or anything like that, but we did look at a couple of them. And the one that I want to have is, first of all, it must do this head thing, so the head must come up and it must support you. So if you're unconscious, it will work. Then I also want to have the light. There's normally a light here, but if I turn like that, then you cannot see the light, so it doesn't work. If I go into a swell, you also, the chance is immediately you don't see the light. So this one that I'm looking at, the light is actually has a little aerial, and the light is blinking, not that high, but I mean my arm is pretty high, but maybe yeah, it's blinking above your head. And then the second thing that I like about this life jacket, and I think by now you guys will know exactly which one I'm talking about, is that it actually makes inside the pontoons, or this thing that blow up, actually a big bright light. No, it's a big bright light.
Oh, light.
So this thing looks like a very big yellow bright thing because there's LED lights inside. So this is quite cool. And very then definitely cool. What I want to have is a little pocket where we put like a MOB, AIS, Automatic Identification System Man Overboard device in. So if you do fall overboard, this thing will immediately kick off and then we will see you on the radar. So if the radar goes off, then we can see you. And remember, we have the FLIR. So from the FLIR camera, we will also then see on the FLIR camera where it is. But I can also see on the radar with IIS where the MOB, the man overboard, is. So that is definitely a must. So it has a little pocket inside, and this thing is inside. Then another pocket is a radio, a waterproof radio. You have a radio, and then also you can tell about, are you heading for me, or you can tell him, all right, we see you. So there can be communication if the guy is still conscious and so on. So you can have communication as well. So just to say, listen, we saw you, we're on our way, don't worry. So that is for the thing, the harnesses. So it has also the thing to clip. Oh, let me just do this. It has the two lanyards that you can actually then clip in. So if you go around the object, you clip first, clip that one in, and clip, you go that side, you carry on.
Oh.
So on the what do you call this, jack lines. Mm. So we can have jack lines, and when the sea conditions is, and it will be, because we're going to go into the into the screaming 60s, what's this other, 50s?
The roaring 40s.
The roaring 40s, and the...
The 50s one is...
I don't know, I remember the 50s.
Vicious, something like vicious 50s or something like that. And the screaming 60s.
So we all go through this, we will definitely need these things. And the Delos crew also went through the roaring 40s. You saw that, and I have absolute awesome video of that. We also saw that episode. We actually saw all of the episodes.
Yeah. Okay, I think number 3 on the agenda for today is security on the boat. What are we going to do? How are we going to do this?
Yeah. Okay, so security. And then again,
we did
today we're referencing live all of the guys. Happy Together. Sailing vessel Happy Together. Awesome, dude. I just love their videos. I just like what the guy is doing with the community. He's also a working guy just like us. Has an absolute marvelous job. Both of us, we have also very good jobs, which we are quitting. We're going to quit very soon. So Happy Together also have had an episode. And also Jessica and Ryan, another sailing channel, also made episodes, which I will have both the links at the bottom if we cannot put all these cards up there. So the links will be at the bottom. So both of them already did the thing about gun controls and guns on boats and things like that. And I agree 100% with them. This is not a gun debate, and I don't want to get into a gun debate. What I do want to have on board is for the opportunistic guys. So the opportunistic thief, I want to, if we're not on boat or if we're sleeping, like the Dallas guy, when he steals the dinghy, I want to know someone is taking the dinghy while I'm sleeping. Or someone is on board while I'm stealing our fishing rods or stuff like that. So the first thing is we will look for the small infrared or maybe a laser beam alarm. One of those things that we will put in that will make a huge noise and put on the lights. Now the problem is, which Ruby Rose at one of the episodes actually mentioned, is if you're not there and this alarm keeps on going off, it's a very annoying thing. I hate alarms that's doing that. So we will definitely try to look for something that doesn't go off that easily.
And it the fellow yachties are going to kill you when they see you. Waking up everybody.
No, so,
not a good idea.
So we want to have an alarm system. The, connected to that, for the opportunistic thief, is that we will have Allen key kind of locks on all of our storage lockers. So the storage lockers will not open with a normal key, will not lock with a normal key, because I think if the key drops, you need to have a locksmith somewhere in the Bahamas or Galapagos Islands or something like that. I'm not sure you will have that. Or even Antarctica, there will definitely not be a lock.
Maybe a couple of ice peaks, but not locksmiths.
Ice peaks. Yeah, we could break the bloody thing if we need to. But yeah, so this will be an Allen key kind of thing. So I would be able to get an Allen key much more easily from a fellow yacht or from somewhere and then open it with Allen keys.
We've had a couple of viewers asking or questioning about the forward cockpit becoming a jacuzzi. What have you found out about that one?
Yeah, so that was one of my concerns as well, the jacuzzi thing. Because if you are in the high seas and the water splash in, that will become a jacuzzi. A lot of water can come in there. And then we discussed this with Leopard, and that was one of their, actually, their certificates. For them to be able to get the certificate, they had to prove that the water can drain out of that one at a very fast rate. So if you put the water level. Completely fill it up, it will drain the water within 45 seconds.
Without coming into the saloon?
Without coming into the saloon. So that's the first thing. So if the water does come in every 45 seconds and fill up that jacuzzi.
It can drain.
But then you have more trouble than the water in a jacuzzi. Because if the sea is that rough, I think at that stage...
You're doing something wrong.
You're at the wrong place at that stage. But yes, it can happen that the jacuzzi has been filled up, but it drains within 45 seconds. So no skinny dipping. You will be fast. You have to be very fast. Then the second thing is the door, the forward cockpit door, is actually designed by Leumar. So Leumar, the hatch guys, they designed it to be a hatch.
Oh,
so
sealed.
It is a very thick safety glass, very sturdy. It has three hatch levers that you actually, so it is actually a hatch. And this is also one of the reasons why the Leopards doesn't have any more escape hatch in the hulls. Because this forward cockpit door is actually the escape hatch.
Wow, and why we picked our name for the dinghy.
Okay, so.
Tell everybody.
No. Let us tell you a little bit of the background.
Yeah, that might be important.
We are not one of those guys that is vegetarians, or we kind of like to go out and meet people and talk to people and pretty social. Ons kuier baie.
Which brings us to another one. I think this is a good time to introduce them to the word lekker as well.
And kuier.
Ons kuier lekker. Now, lekker is a true South African Afrikaans word. There's just no parallel to the meaning of that word. It's just like everything nice amplified a million times. Awesome amplified a million times. That's lekker. And say it.
And it's also
lekker to say lekker.
It's also a very versatile word. Because you can say, oh, you're lekker. But it's not that she's sweet. But also, a sweet is lekker. Because that's the taste
candy.
Is sweet. That's also lekker. Or this beer is lekker, which is not sweet. But it is a nice taste.
Or it's a lekker day. In other words, it's nice sunshine, it's beautiful weather.
Yeah, very versatile.
It's lekker, yeah.
So lekker. And then kuier. Kuier is like socializing. But like a braai. A barbecue. A South African braai.
Yeah.
We kuier a lot around the braai because you talk, you discuss things, and you make jokes, and it's like a very nice social event. We kuier, no? We like to kuier.
And then we kuier lekker.
And then that's where we start to get a little bit of a memory loss.
So that is where the name is going to come from, or is coming from. It's from keiring too lekker, you've got memory loss. And what wipes out memory better than?
Tippex. So you guys have, the old guys like me and there, you know what Tippex is. Is when you write stuff and it's like, oops, you made a mistake, and you just like put this white stuff, you know, you Tippex it out. So we will Tippex our minds every now and then. So then the boat, little boat's name will be Tippex. Because it will be many, many moons will be coming from a lekker keier and we will forget stuff. So Tippex. Yeah, the so boat's name will be Tippex.
Just two Tippex,
huh? Yeah, two Tippex. So next week's episode will be again Pietro's turn to do all the research. We did already a lot of research. It will be the scuba gear and foldable bikes. It is time for you to get out of that full screen and hit the red subscribe button if you have not done that. It is free. Also, next to the subscribe button is a little bell button which you can click, which is also free. This will notify you when we release a new video. Then if you like the video, you can go over to our like button and then click that one too. It is free as well. Then if you want to follow our social media in real time, you can go over to Facebook and you can like the page as well, so you will be notified there. That's also free. Then if you want to look at all the nice pictures that Pietro is taking, and she's becoming quite a photographer, go over to Instagram and like the photos there. That is also free. Which is not free is that if you like our information that we give you, if you think we contributed something to your knowledge, or that we entertain you, or that, yeah, well, you just liked us, you can go over to a Patreon site and you can tip us over there. Thank you very much for our subscribers, and a very big thank you for all the Patreons that's already thinking that we're contributing something to their lives. Thank you very much. See you next week.